I would like to call the public hearing to order pursuant to a notice. We're here for a public hearing for Governor Cuomo's Court of Appeal nominee Rowan Wilson. The purpose of the hearing is to fill the vacancy of recently retired Judge Eugene Pickett Jr. On behalf of the committee, and I'm sure all of our members in the legislature, we want to thank Judge Pickett for his many years of integrity and exemplary service to the Court of Appeals. I also would like to acknowledge two distinguished guests that are with me today. The Honorable Chief Judge Janet D. Fiore and the Associate Court of Appeals Judge Leslie Stein. Thank you for joining us today. At this time, I would also like to acknowledge our ranking member of the Senate Judiciary Committee, Senator Brad Hoylman. I look forward to working with him on this committee throughout the session. For this public hearing, we'll have two witnesses providing oral testimony regarding Mr. Wilson's qualifications. The witnesses appearing before the committee will be Vincent Doyle, past president and current chair of the New York State Bar Association Committee to Review Judicial Nominations. And the second speaker will be Edward Gershowitz, president of the New York State Trial Lawyers Association. I want you to know that there were many requests to have more speakers that were so impressed with this nominee, but we wanted to keep it short because we have a full day today, not only what we'll be doing here today, but we have other heavy stuff happening on the floor. Each witness will be limited to 5 minutes of oral testimony, followed by questions from members of the committee. In addition, written testimony has been submitted to the Judiciary Committee regarding Mr. Wilson, which will be included in the record. I circulated the resume of Mr. Wilson to the Judiciary Committee members on Monday, January 30, to provide an overview of the nominee. At this time, I would like to call up Vincent Doyle III to testify. Vincent, where are you?
Right here, Senator.
Okay, good man.
Good to see you again, Senator. Thank you. Senator Bonacek, members of the Senate Judiciary Committee, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Vincent Doyle. I am a past president of the New York State Bar Association and the current chair of the association's committee to review judicial nominations. It is my privilege to appear before you today in support of the appointment of Rowan D. Wilson as associate judge of the New York State Court of Appeals. On behalf of the association, I thank you for the opportunity to testify concerning Mr. Wilson's qualifications for that position. I would like first to outline for you the process by which our association evaluates Court of Appeals candidates. Our committee to review judicial nominations is appointed by the association's president and made up of 17 members and 4 alternate members from across New York State. Every judicial district is represented on the committee. Consistent with the overall policies of our association, the committee appointments reflect the diversity of our membership and society as a whole, diversity of race, gender, geography, and thought. Members are also selected so that a wide variety of practice areas are represented, with a special emphasis, obviously, on appellate practice. Upon the announcement by the Commission on Judicial Nomination of its list of candidates for appointment to the Court of Appeals, our committee chair appoints subcommittees to investigate the qualifications of each candidate. These subcommittees review biographical material provided by the candidate, read samples of the writings of the candidate, interview persons familiar with the candidate's work, background, and character. In the case of judges who have been nominated, the subcommittee include in their interviews lawyers who have appeared before the judge. Finally, the subcommittees meet with the candidates personally. Based on the information gathered during the investigation process, the subcommittees prepare reports and recommendations concerning the candidates and present them to the full committee. After the completion of these investigations, the committee meets as a whole to review the subcommittee reports concerning the qualifications of each candidate and to personally interview the candidates. In the case of candidates who were recently interviewed by the committee in connection with prior nominations, personal interviews are sometimes waived. The committee then votes to determine the candidate's rating. In making their evaluations, the committee members are asked to consider the candidate's professional ability and experience, character, temperament, and the possession of the special qualities necessary or desirable for the judicial office sought. With respect to the present nomination, we have found Mr. Wilson to be well-qualified to serve as an associate judge of the Court of Appeals. A well-qualified candidate is one who, in addition to possessing the qualities necessary for service as an associate judge, possesses preeminent qualifications for that judicial office. Well-qualified is our highest rating. Mr. Wilson was previously nominated for the position of associate judge in prior years and for the position of chief judge in 2015. After being selected as a candidate by the Commission on Judicial Nominations for this vacancy, Judge Pigott's, Mr. Wilson's qualifications were evaluated again by our committee in accordance with the procedures I outlined. As a result of this investigation and interview, it was the opinion of our committee that Mr. Wilson is well qualified for this position. Mr. Wilson possesses strong skills that we believe will serve him well as an associate judge. He has been a partner at Cravath, Swain, and Moore since 1992, and has handled a wide variety of cases, including complex commercial and civil rights matters. Currently, he supervises the firm's pro bono work. He is the board chair of the Neighborhood Defender Services of Harlem, a public defense practice that seeks to provide both criminal defense and social service support for its clients. He is well known among the lawyers and judges of this state for his intellect, diligence, and professionalism. I personally have the additional benefit of knowing someone, a former partner of mine, who is now a law professor, James Duane, who is a classmate of Mr. Wilson's at Harvard Law. I consider Professor Duane to be one of the smartest people I know, and he describes Mr. Wilson as the smartest person he's ever met. Yeah. It's a very high recommendation to me.
You didn't ask his wife that question, did you?
I did not. I'm smarter than that, Senator. But on behalf of the New York State Bar Association, I am pleased to endorse Rowan Wilson's appointment to the Court of Appeals and urge the confirmation of this appointment. Thank you for your attention and for inviting participation by the New York State Bar Association in this important process.
Mr. Doyle, thank you. Anyone have any questions of Mr. Doyle? Okay, we thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator.
And before I call the next speaker, let me introduce Grace Rowan, who's sitting in the back there, with her three daughters, Isabel, Anna, and Eleanor. We thank you for joining us today. And to my left is Brielle Christian, our new Judiciary Counsel. So if any members of our committee have any questions, don't ask me. Ask Brielle. Okay, our next speaker now will be Mr. Gershowitz.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you, members of the committee. I've had the pleasure of reading a little bit about the three daughters and the candidates, the nominees' submissions, basically, and also in meeting with the nominee when we met with him at the Algonquin Hotel with the New York State Trial Lawyers Association Committee. And it was quite an interesting meeting. And in any event, good afternoon. My name is Edward H. Gershowitz. I'm the president of the New York State Trial Lawyers Association. I appear today on behalf of our association and our 3,500 attorney members who practice in trial and appellate courts throughout our great state. Thank you, Chairman, for inviting NISLA to participate today and for the opportunity to speak in support of the governor's nomination of Rowan D. Wilson for Associate Judge of the New York State Court of Appeals. The appointment of a new judge to our state's highest court is of great significance to our citizens who depend upon careful application of the law by each of our court's members and who rely upon our court to serve as the guardians of their equal access to the civil justice system. Since 2013, NISLA's judiciary panel has had the opportunity to interview Rowan Wilson no less than six times for openings on the court. Through those meetings, we have come to know him as an unassuming person of extraordinary intellect, quiet reason, and keen insight, all seasoned with a measure of low-key humor. He comes to you with our association's highest rating, highly qualified and highly recommended, and I'm pleased and honored to carry that endorsement to you today. He has a distinguished 30-year legal career serving both the bar and the community. He will bring to the court's collaborative decision-making process a background in complex commercial litigation, an area important to our state's preeminence in commercial matters. Equally, though, and perhaps more importantly, is Mr. Wilson's experience in and dedication to pro bono work as chair of Cravath's pro bono department and as reflected, as Vincent said, in his service to communities in need. His work as chair of the Board of Trustees of the Neighborhood Defender Service of Harlem has helped thousands to obtain access to legal services and equal protection under the law. Similarly, he is a member of the Board of Directors of Wide Horizon for Children, a nonprofit organization focused on child welfare. Access to the courts. Access to the courts is a right that is critical for protecting the disadvantaged as well as the powerful. Mr. Wilson has demonstrated his commitment to that precept throughout his legal career. We welcome Rowan Wilson's commitment to justice and community and look forward to his confirmation, hopefully, as an associate judge of the Court of Appeals. Thank you again for the opportunity to testify here today.
Thank you, Mr. Gerswitz. Anyone have any questions? Senator Hoyland.
Hi.
Hello,
nice to
Senator.
See you. Nice to see you, Mr. Gerswitz.
Thank you.
I think it speaks volumes that the representative of the plaintiff's bar is here to support someone who comes from the defense bar. And I was wondering if you could expound on that, why you think, even with Mr. Wilson's extensive experience in representing corporate America, that he's suitable for this job.
Thank you for that question. I think a lot of that comes down to looking past someone's resume and basically doing a gut check when you sit down to speak with someone. Obviously, from his CV, if you will, it's apparent that he doesn't have experience in our so-called field of practice in personal injury law, consumer rights, and protecting the rights of the dispossessed and the disadvantaged. However, what he does not possess in terms of actual legal experience on a day-in, day-out, for-profit type of job, he certainly has made up for in his work as the pro bono head of Cravath's department. We've met with him 6 times. And over those 6 periods of time, it was a pleasure every time we sat down with him. He is just, he's what we would refer to as a mensch. He is just a decent human being, and I think that he will give equal hearing to the powerful, the disadvantaged, and to the people who are basically hurt through no fault of their own through negligence. So we're pretty confident that he'll be great with the collaborative process, and we think that he's terrific.
Well, Mr. Gerswitz, you're a mensch, so it takes one to know one.
Thank you. Thank you very
Any
much.
Other questions?
Yes.
You, Mike, do you want to speak?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, Senator Brazenhoff.
Thank you, Chairman. First of all, I'd like to thank Mr. Gerswitz, and I was remiss for not making the comments when Mr. Doyle was there, for doing a lot of the research, and I've mentioned this before with other nominees, in terms of the interviews and the investigations and the checking things out. It certainly doesn't detract from what we have to do individually as senators, but I would be remiss if I didn't thank your association and the Bar Association. I also, when I was talking with Mr. Doyle earlier, he told me that this will be his last presentation before this committee. He's been here many times on behalf of the Bar Association, and I just want to thank your leadership, both you and Mr. Doyle, on behalf of both associations for the work that you do in interviewing and really vetting and providing recommendations to us. They're not determinative by any stretch of the imagination, but to me, they're certainly helpful. And again, as part of my own independent research and the work that I do, helpful in my deliberations. So thank you, Mr. Gerswitz and Mr. Doyle. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Senator. Is that
okay? Any other questions, Mr. Gerswitz? Hearing none, I thank you very much for coming today.
And before I get up, I'll get up first, but I would be remiss if I didn't say hello to the distinguished members of the Court of Appeals, the Chief Judges here today, and Judge Stein as well. Thank you for everything that you do for your state. Thank you.
Okay. In addition to the testimony we've heard and received today, we've received written submissions that are available in the public record as well, that are currently before the committee on the Judiciary Committee website. This includes submission from the New York State Academy of Trial Lawyers, submitted February 1st, 2017. We've also received communication concerning Mr. Wilson, and they were all the highest rankings possible, from the New York City Bar Association, as we said, the Academy of Trial Lawyers, the Women's Bar Association of the State of New York, Tri-County Bar Association, the Women's Trial Lawyers Caucus, the Albany Bar Association, and the Broome County Bar Association. This will conclude the public hearing portion. We'll take a brief recess for about 5 minutes and then convene a meeting of the Judiciary Committee when the nominee, Rowan Wilson, will appear and address the committee. The public hearing is now closed. Thank you very much.